to this.
To keep abreast with the many technical improvements of today's large fan engines, similar technical growth is required and seen in the repair process of these complex machines. Most critical to this process is the test facility, which provides the final assurance that these engines are airworthy before being installed on the aircraft. This presentation will discuss the basic operational features of a modern fan jet engine test facility. Features such as engine preparation area, test chamber, computerized control and instrumentation system, aerodynamic and acoustical systems. The primary use of the test cell is to perform post-overhaul testing of the engine. Also, the engines are quite often tested prior to disassembly for diagnostic reasons. This pre-run, as it's normally called, will assist in pinpointing the specific problem with the engine, as well as provide a performance baseline that can be compared to after the engine is repaired. From final assembly, the engine is brought to the preparation area of the test facility. Adjacent to the test chamber, this area usually can accommodate several engines as they prepare for test. This process entails fitting the engine with specific equipment, such as temperature, pressure, and vibration probes, inlet bell mouth, testing cowling, and most importantly, the engine adapter is attached. This critical item is the primary structural interface between the engine and the facility-mounted thrust stand. It supports the engine in the same manner as the engine is supported on an aircraft wing. Fuel, air start, Firex, pressure sense lines, and instrumentation harnesses pass through the adapter and up through the coupling plate. After the engine is completely prepped for test, the entire adapter engine assembly is transported into the test cell and located on the ceiling-mounted thrust stand. As you can see, this is accomplished by using a monorail delivery system. The engine adapter assembly slowly approaches the thrust stand and lowers and locks the entire assembly safely and efficiently. After this, the adapter is locked into the thrust stand, followed by mating the thrust stand and adapter coupling plates together. All services, fuel, air, pressure sense lines, and electrical harnessing passes through this critical interface and on into the control room. The control room is located next to the test cell and preparation area. To ensure complete acoustical and vibrational isolation from the test environment, the control room is structurally separate from the test chamber. The control room houses the engine control and instrumentation system for the entire test cell facility. The basic purpose of this system is to provide the overall function for control and monitoring of an engine under test. It controls functions such as onboard valves and switches, engine power levels, facility equipment, and communicates with the new electronic engine controls. It monitors engine and facility functions and various other critical parameters to ascertain the current health and status of the engine under test. In addition, the system outputs the data in various forms, such as screen displays, printed media, and magnetic tape storage. With the advent of modern computer systems, test data is collected and reduced in a matter of milliseconds, thereby significantly reducing the actual runtime of a particular test. With this real-time system, the performance of the engine is immediately known, allowing the operator to determine the status of the engine in a quick and efficient manner. The performance data is also used with advanced trending software to aid the on-wing condition monitoring of the engine, as well as assist in test cell management and logistics. The control console is the primary interface between the operator and the engine, and also with the test facility itself. Shown here is a state-of-the-art 5-bay computer console featuring 3 data display CRTs, 2 closed-circuit TV monitors, programmable engine control module, which provides control of engine operating functions, facility control module, which provides control of all facility-related operating functions. Power lever transmitter, which provides control of the engine power lever and fuel shutoff lever. Special function keyboard allows the operator to communicate directly with the computer system. Other major components located in the control room are the host computer cabinets and various peripherals. As this computerized control and instrumentation system seeks to control and monitor the engine in a safe and efficient manner, the functional design of the test cell chamber strives to do the same while trying to simulate the engine on wing. When tested in a cell, the engines are sheltered from their natural working environment. Aerodynamically, the engine requires very smooth airflow. The test cell has to recreate that environment. Forward of the engine, the inlet section smooths out the airflow as it approaches the engine. This is achieved by utilizing specific aerodynamic elements, such as inlet turning vanes to aid the transition from vertical to horizontal airflow. Just downstream of the turning vanes are three rows of acoustically absorbent baffles positioned to smooth out the airflow, as well as help attenuate engine inlet noise, the high-frequency whining noise that emanates from the engine fan. Finally, an inlet screen is located just downstream of the baffles to further ensure uniform distribution of inlet air. It also serves to prevent entry of foreign objects into the test cell. In the areas around the engine and thrust stand, wall-mounted acoustic panels, although not used here, can also be used to further attenuate the engine, as well as add to the aerodynamic profile of the cell by concealing certain areas and equipment. Downstream of the engine, the test cell exhaust system is located, consisting of an augmenter tube, a perforated basket, and an exhaust stack or tower treated with acoustic baffles. The augmenter tube captures the heated air core exhaust and fan discharge air from the engine, as well as test cell bypass air that flows around the engine under test. A properly designed augmenter tube will allow complete mixing of these air masses as they exit the tube, in this case, 50 feet downstream. This mixing also greatly reduces the exhaust stack temperatures, which simplifies the design and construction of the exhaust stack sound attenuation elements. In many test cells, this tube is also acoustically treated to help attenuate engine exhaust sound levels. Discharge from the tube enters a large perforated basket or an exhaust grid that diffuses and helps transition the horizontal to vertical airflow. The basket also serves as an acoustical element as it breaks up the rumbling low-frequency airflow into smaller jets of high-frequency airflows as it passes through the many small openings. Finally, the exhaust stack acoustic treatment is mounted directly above the basket or grid. As shown here, a tubular system is used consisting of 64 tuned exhaust mufflers to efficiently attenuate the exhaust noise at selected frequencies. Exhaust baffles, similar to the ones used in the inlet section, can also be used. In addition to the various acoustical elements, the test cell also uses heavy entrance doors and thick armor-plated viewing windows to further provide a quiet environment within the test cell and, most importantly, in the adjacent surroundings outside the test cell. New techniques and improved materials help test cell designers to keep abreast and ahead of the increasingly stringent standards of noise abatement. Facilities such as this one are designed to easily operate in a noise-restricted area, even during nighttime hours when strict curfew regulations curtail operations of jet aircraft. In summary, the modern fan engine test facility maintains a critical role in the repair and overhaul cycle of aircraft engines. The sophisticated computerized control and instrumentation system works in concert with the test cell itself to provide a cost-efficient, safe, and environmentally compatible operation that's absolutely essential for airlines of the 1990s.